just was trembling the entire night. And I said, I was like, God, please, I don't want him to think I'm crazy or anything. But I really didn't care about that either. But I told him because he knew when I was seeking God. Because we live in a little bitty apartment. And the TV is on the wall. It's big enough. It's like on the wall. You could be in the kitchen, you watching TV. You could be in the bed, you watching TV. You could be in my closet, you watching TV. And he got his stuff on. And I'm on the other side, facing the wall, so I can't see the TV, and I have my headphones on in my ear. Sometimes I remember riding with him, and he would have his music on. You know, I would like for him to respect me, but everything that everybody do to you, you can't respond to, you know, especially when you can't, and I learned that even now, you can't respond to every little wrong thing somebody do to you, because, I mean, you'd be going off for days if that was the case, and the devil was using him. He would turn the stuff on TV, people cursing, and rappers, and Lil Wayne, this, and Jay-Z. I could have been like, are you serious? You know what I stand for? No, I didn't say anything. I just chose not to look at it. When I got in his car, he had a right to bump his music. I'm not going, okay, let's go, whatever. I didn't say anything. I didn't, because I had something bigger in my mind than me just getting my feelings out to him, how I felt. And I just remember having my headphones on, and he like, well, I hope you really get what you're trying to get. Because I remember him telling me that he saw me when I was singing, I really hope you get what you're trying to get. Because I had went to Walgreens and bought like a board you can hang up on the wall, right on. And I said, top goal, Holy Ghost. I put it on. See what I do. Say thank you, Jesus, every time you can. So oh, I wouldn't forget. And he like, okay, wow. He really looked like she done gone crazy. I remember even sitting up in school when I'm supposed to be thinking about my work. Every second I get out, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And even now, even after I got it, I try to remember that. Thank you, Jesus, all day, all through the day. Because even though I already have him, if I don't do anything to keep him, I will come to church dry as and still as an old piece of bread. It'll be like I'm not, and I can't sit in the service and not feel his presence. That is no point in me being. I have to feel his presence. When you come in the door, it's just a different praise. And I mean, I can praise God all day in my house. But when I get into the house, when I walk into the store, when I'm driving from the driveway, it's just like a lighting a match to create a flame. It's just instant. It's nothing like it. I can't come in. I have to feel his presence. I can't afford to, not at least give him a, I don't want this to be my first time saying to him when I walk in the door. I travel, even when I'm in class. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. When I see somebody act like they don't like me, God help them. Jesus, help them. Yes. I just thank God. I thank God for the Holy Ghost. It is truly something wonderful. It's so many. I think people kind of get like stuck in their ways or whatever, and they just feel like they seek a little bit and then they kind of give up because that's what I was doing. You get discouraged. You get angry at people. You get frustrated. I remember thinking like, this is not gonna, I cannot get the, the devil was telling me I was a reprobate. I mean, even before I got saved, he was telling me, you know better. You know you can't get saved. You out here, it's over with. God will put somebody else in your place. So I use that. I say, okay, well, I'm going to show you if I'm a reprobate or not. A reprobate can't get the Holy Ghost. A reprobate don't have a mind to live right and to want to right. A reprobate don't have that. And he would still talk to me. The devil would still just keep talking to me. But I could not let that be my reason of giving up because at the end of the day, it's my fault if I'm not seeking. I don't have anybody else to blame but myself. Right. But I just think people just get like kind of stuck and discouraged. But you guys just kind of just gotta get that and keep going until something happens. Right. And even when something happens, you still gotta keep going because whatever you, I God, right, whatever you have to do to get the Holy Ghost, that's what you got to do to keep it, you know? When Rashawn has stuff on TV now, I could just feel myself pulling away from it. If I decide to, I could just feel something inside of me. Like, if certain conversations are going, I could just, it's like something inside. Almost, I want to vomit almost. Certain things, like, the Holy Ghost can't take it. And I refuse to let anything, I mean, it's not worth it.
That's right.
It's not worth it. Amen. I need him in my life. And I just thank God. I just keep seeking God. And God knows how much you can do. You might not can do as much as somebody else did. Or, you know, you might not could, you know. But God knows how much you can do. As long as you try your best, he'll do the rest. So I just thank God and pretty much
beautiful. Amen. Oh.